the problem was much deeper than just simply community safety. The initiative came up in the first place saying we will never be able to get enough police officers in order to service the community and make everybody less crime prone. It needs to be a bigger picture.
Harder says City Council believed more needed to be done to support people before they fell through the cracks, helping them before police intervention was ever needed. That same year, Harder announced at a State of the City address the creation of the Safe Communities Initiative. The idea would eventually become the Community Care Program at Central Station. The concept was simple: build a team of people including police, social workers, school liaisons, and health workers, launching their lives onto a new path. Their motto, no shame, no blame, helping families who feel like they're spinning their tires. Tash Olford is one of the Community Care Program directors and explains they meet with families and individuals once a month, breaking down their goals into smaller, achievable steps.
One of my people, her dream was to go to school. And at the time, you sort of look at the circumstances of life and you think, you can't see that end goal. It looks far away. But she is in post-secondary education, getting her and she just needed someone to believe in her and walk alongside her and say, you can do this.
She notes the program is working.
The city of Winkler has become a place that is catching people who are falling through the cracks, right? They want to move forward. They're in crisis, perhaps, but there is light at the end of the tunnel, and they want to change the trajectory of their lives so that they're not going from one crisis to the next.
In 2019, Mayor Harder says they were shocked to see the crime rate had dropped, even as Winkler continues to be one of the fastest growing cities in the country.
That's just a misnomer. Your crime rate should not go down when the population rate goes up, but that's exactly what we're seeing here.
However, Harder says the key is empathy and humility. No one should ever believe they're immune to the need for support.
Life takes different turns, and we are only this far away from being in the same boat. Circumstances can change in my life, they can change in your life, that actually would bring us to that level. We are very fortunate that we aren't there, but yet we need to make sure that the people who are there, who are given a hand up, they are in a situation where they have left their comfort zone, they're in a very uncomfortable place, and unless we have a program in place that helps them to realize that there is hope for tomorrow, they will go down that path of destruction. What we're trying to take as people who see that there's no hope, and to give them a glimmer of hope and say, work on this, and then we'll see where that gets you, and then work on the next step and see where that gets you. That's what makes it exciting for me to be a part of this community and see the volunteers that are pouring their life into these people's lives to make a difference. And we appreciate it. And I have said to my council, and I've said it to this group, there will be many programs that will be cut long before this one will ever be cut, because this is really the difference maker.
The community care program is not a quick fix solution, and can take anywhere from 4 months to a year for people to graduate. But organizers insist that's also the secret to the program's early success stories, helping people realize they have a choice, and with the support of a team and their community, there is hope for the future.